You got questions, we've got answers. Just ask Kenan.
What's going on, everyone? Kenan here, hanging out with my leopard tortoises, and I've got the final Ask Camp Kenan question for October, although it is the first Camp Kenan question for November. You confused? I am too. Anyway, let's get to the question, shall we? And this question is from Dylan Cloud, one of our Patreon supporters. He's looking to purchase either captive bred leopard or redfoots with the plan to have them outdoors. I like it when the time comes. With that in mind, he's thinking of purchasing several, about four or five, as close together as possible in size, but would like to get them from different sellers if possible so that the bloodlines are separate. And he's asking, what would be my recommendation on how to acclimate the tortoises? All right, so first things first, we're looking here at a Florida-raised leopard tortoise. It's kind of a drizzly, cool day. And for most leopard tortoises that are not from Florida, say, for example, I got leopard tortoises from Arizona. And I brought them out here to South Florida and basically tried to get them going. Wouldn't work. It's just very difficult to get leopard tortoises acclimated to our high humidity and rainy days. You should always try and find someone with the babies you want in an area that is very similar to yours. So, for example, anyone who buys leopard tortoises from me, if they're from a high humid area like New Orleans or anywhere in the South, or if they're going to keep the animal up north indoors, you can buy from me because these animals can take humid situations. You know, if you raise them up as hatchlings, they do much better in that regard. Here's another one, just the back end of one hiding underneath these tussocks of grass. And we have a light rain and they are dry to the touch. So it's really amazing how this grass keeps these guys going. So as far as acclimating these animals, I'd say it's important to start with babies, as you are going to, Dylan. Start with babies and then make sure they came from a similar climate as you. Now, you're never going to be able to acclimate them for the cold and wet. Any tortoise that gets cold and wet is going to be in trouble. And so what I'm doing right now is I'm going to pull a few of these guys in, because I know we're going to keep getting a drizzle. And like I said, it's low 70s, which probably isn't so bad, but I don't like to risk the leopard tortoises. I always feel like they're a little bit more delicate, shall I say, or just susceptible to respiratory problems if they aren't kept dry. Now, they can get cooler. Now, by cooler, I don't mean freezing. I just mean in the 60s, but it's got to be dry. If it's 60s and wet, we're going to have a problem. Now let's walk over to the Redfoots and see what they're doing. Redfoots are a little bit more hardy. However, the reverse is true. I have friends out in Phoenix, Arizona. It gets 120 degrees out in the Southwest, and it's very dry as it is a desert. Now, your Redfoots are from South America, and it's very humid. They wander through forests and grasslands, but it is humid. So being out in the desert, you have the opposite problem. How are you going to keep them moist? How are you going to keep the air out there humid enough so that they don't get a respiratory problem and have issues down the line? I wouldn't recommend keeping them out there. I have friends who don't keep them out there because it's just too dry. Here's one of my large males. Here's his area. I guess, Dylan, if I'm answering your question, buddy, it's important for me to know where you live. Basically, if you live someplace where it's humid, then you should get the redfoot tortoise. If you live someplace where it's dry and hot, I would recommend the good old leopard tortoise. All right, I hope this has answered your question. I'm signing off right now, as is that redfoot tortoise. He's making a break for it. I guess he doesn't like me. Anyway, everybody, I will see you again real soon. Don't forget to become a Patreon member, and you can get your own question asked right here on our channel. Thanks so much, and I'll talk to you soon. Take care.